Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel
from
Valley View Farms. We're in the middle of November, and it looks like it's about time to put bulbs in the ground. The ideal time, really.
It really is. We've had a couple of frosts. All I have to do is find mine at home because I put them somewhere so I could, you know, do them on time, but I wanted to get all of them when they were still available. But now's the time to go ahead and get out there and get them planted.
How late can we go?
Until the ground freezes. There was one year here where I had to plant over 19,000 bulbs with a crew, and we actually did it on January 5th. So as long as you have about 12 weeks between planting and when they are supposed to come up, that's about the average dormancy for most of these, you're fine.
Okay, so now another controlling factor here. So we've had some really wet weather this fall so far, so you don't want the ground really mushy when you do this.
Right, check your area first. You can maybe pick up some soil. If it goes into a ball, it doesn't come out of it, then it's still too wet. You can throw it down on the ground. If it crumbles, then you're going to be fine.
Okay, all right, so the ground here is still a little on the damp side. Do we need to fertilize now?
You know, there's a couple schools of thought. If you're going to use an organic fertilizer like bulb tone or bone meal, mm-hmm. you really don't have to now, but you're not going to hurt anything.
Right.
Because the fertilizer is going to stay in the ground until the plant calls for it. The best time to fertilize bulbs is actually in the spring, once they're finished flowering and they start to die back.
So there's no pre-treatment, so to speak.
Unless.
Okay.
You got this little guy. Okay.
Okay.
Many of you have probably had problems with little varmints, whether they be chipmunks or squirrels or, you know, something, digging things up and digging the bulbs up. Things like daffodils aren't a problem because they're toxic to pests. So
right.
They're and pets. But anyway, they're not going to get into them. Bobex or some of these other animal repellents will work very well. Soak them in these overnight.
So you put this liquid in a bucket and let the tulips, in this case,
just soak in there and you're fine. And the other trick is plant these a little deeper than you think they should be. In general, we say 3 to 4 times the diameter of the bulb deep. Well, once you get down about that deep, a chipmunk's really not going to bother it. You might get some squirrels down there, but they're not going to dig far. So if you get down to like 6 to 8 inches, you can really avoid some of that damage that way too.
Okay, now speaking of digging, and we have only about a minute and a half left, this is kind of the old-fashioned way to dig, and I'm going to try it out and see what happens.
Give it a go, okay.
Give it a go. Oh.
This is a bulb planter, and you can also get hand bulb planters, so you
can
do it either way.
I've run into something. Oh, there we go. I've got it.
And that's nice because that gives you a nice plug, and just drop your bulb in there, and you're ready to go.
Flat side down, pointy side up, right?
Very good. And in case you get it mixed up, you know, it's going to come up towards light anyway, so you ought to be okay.
Then the next problem is getting that clod of dirt out of there.
If it were easy, anybody could do it, right?
Right.
Usually
I'll work on that later.
Usually have a garden trowel or something coming. But
well, you know
the
what?
Other...
I'll use the drill.
That's right.
Which is the next one we're going to show. To get that out of there. There we go.
Very good. Tim the Toolman Taylor on
there.
The job.
I don't think it was intended to do it that way. The other way is to use one of these cool things. Whoop. There seems to be some stones in there.
But that's a nice way. And drop a hole in there. And the other way to do it, of course, you can use a simple trowel. If you tend to plant mm-hmm. in groups, you can also use a shovel. And just drop those down. And again, 6 to 8 inches for a lot of these bigger bulbs is plenty big.
Didn't get quite deep enough. You know, I'm almost thinking that other one worked better because this is a challenge.
It's all up to you. There are some of these augers too that you don't have to stoop as much. They're
right.
A little bit longer.
Taller.
Yeah, so that helps.
Whoa! There we go.
We're putting time to give it a workout today.
Almost live television. Nothing's perfect. Well, you know what? After today's experience, I'll vote for this.
There you go. Fair enough.
For this.
Get yourself a nice sturdy one like that. There are some other ones that in our clay soils don't quite hold up. So if you're going to be doing a lot of bulb digging, make it easier on yourself.
Okay, and we're out of time.
Okay.
Good luck with your bulbs, Carrie.
Thanks, you
good
too.
Good luck with your bulbs out there. And you know what? Next Sunday we'll be back with more. We'll experiment some more with all of this stuff on your Sunday garden. Oh, that went in nice and easy there, see? There we go. Hey, that's really good. We'll see you later.
I think John is an expert now. If you have a garden question, send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. You can also go on our website, WBALTV.com.